So friends, we are dealing with the problem number, I think once again I will repeat this, page number 165 in the book, example 9.4, a crane fish flying, a crane, not fish, a crane flying 6 meters above a still clear water. Crane means a name of the bird. That bird is flying 6 meters above the surface of the water. This is the surface of the water. This is 6 meters above the surface of the water. Then, for the crane, the fish appears to be 6 centimeters below the surface of the water. For this bird, this fish inside the water is appearing to be 6 centimeters below the surface of the water. So therefore, here a real height of bird, crane, or we call it a crane, real height of the crane bird is 6 meters. Then, apparent of fish is 6 centimeters. Then, what they are asking, how much deep should the crane immerse its beak to pick up the fish? Means the beak, manje choch, how much deep it has to immerse inside the water to find out the, or to catch the fish inside the water. So that means we have to find out the, what is called as a real depth of the, what is called as the fish. So we have to find out the real depth of the fish. And from the fish point of view, what is the apparent height of the crane bird? Manje ya fish drushtikonatun to kiti var ahe, that is apparent height. And ya crane bird cha drushtikonatun a fish khara khara kiti khol ahe te aplyala kalayche. So all of you know that here when the bird looks the, a crane looks the fish at that time, here the refractive index of what is called as water with respect to air we have to take. They are given refractive index of water with respect to air is, they are given I think 4 by 3. In the problem, the refractive index is 4 by 3, water. So therefore, the first question is refractive index of water with respect to air is equal to real depth of the fish upon apparent depth of the fish. Real depth of the fish upon apparent depth of the fish. So, real depth of the fish is equal to, real depth of the fish is equal to, here we have to find out, so real depth of the fish is equal to refractive index of water with respect to air into apparent depth of the fish. Real depth of the water with respect to air. Real depth of the water with respect to air. Or refractive index of water with respect to air is 4 by 3 into apparent 6 centimeter. So that will be equal to 2. So 8 centimeter. Means the bird has to immerse. Bird has to immerse its beak in water 8 centimeter below. Then the next question is that according to the fish point of view, at how much height is the bird? Again, refractive index of air with respect to water. Because the light is traveling from denser to rarer. So refractive index of air with respect to water. Ultra gaisa. So, refractive index of air with respect to water is equal to 4 by 3, instead of 4 by 3, it will be 3 by 4. It will be 3 by 4. Then, what you will get? 3 by 4 here, that is equal to, again, a real of what is called as a fish upon apparent of the fish. Then we have to find out the apparent, crane bird, instead of fish, we have to take the crane bird. Okay. Then, apparent of the crane, or we have to take, this will be the real, 6 centimeter. And apparent will be the, what is that? What they have to calculate? Here we have to find out the apparent height is to be determined. So apparent height is equal to 3 by 4 into is equal to what you can write? Crane, real height is 6. Real height is 6. So therefore, real of the crane divided by or directly you can put the value here. Why have to put like this? Here it will be equal to 3 by 4 is equal to real height is crane fish is crane bird is how much? 6 centimeter upon apparent of the crane. So apparent of the crane is equal to 4 by 3 into again 6, because this 4 go here, 3 will be numerator, 3 will be here, 2. So 4 twos are what is called as a 8 meter, because this 6 is in meter, real height is 6 in meter. Therefore, the crane bird will appear, the crane bird will appear 8 meter above the water surface to fish, 8 meter above the water surface to fish. Okay, so therefore, for the crane bird, the fish is 8 centimeter below, and for the fish, the crane bird is 8 meter above the surface of the water. So 8 centimeter deep the fish is, and for the fish, the bird is about 8 meter above the surface of the water. Okay, this is the problem we have seen. Now after this, we have to go for the next one, is total internal reflection. Total internal reflection. What is meant by the total internal reflection of the light? See here. Total internal reflection of light. You see here, basic principle is that when light travel from denser medium to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. When light travel from denser medium to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. You see here, again, there is a figure for this total internal reflection of the light. For the figure, you see here, this is the first one. Here is the position of the what is called as of the object here, two objects. This is the surface separating the two mediums. Okay. Or again we can take somewhat this side so that we can clearly show. This is the first, second, third, and fourth. You see here, fourth one. First, second, third, see here the light ray will go like this. I will draw the normals here. I is equal to IC, less than IC, there is also I less than IC. So what is the IC? I will tell you later on. First of all, you see this figure. You see, IC is nothing but the critical angle. Critical angle. Here, this is 90. This is R. This is also R. This is I greater than IC. Object vertically. Okay. So what I am telling you, total internal reflection. So in the textbook also they have shown the figure like this. Here I2, I1, I2, I3. Angle of incidence, angle of refraction. They have given, taken these as names as I1. Here is I2. Here is I3. And here is I4. They are given like this names. R1, R2, R3 and R4. For the first, here they have taken this as names as, they are not given any name there. So this is optically rarer medium. Optically rarer medium. Optically denser medium. सो लाइट इज ट्रॅव्हलिंग फ्रॉम डेन्सर मीडियम टू रेअर मीडियम. म्हणजे तुम्ही काय समजायचं, दिस इज अ सरफेस सेपरेटिंग द टू मीडियम. दिस इज द सरफेस, वी कॉल इट एज एक्स वाय, सपोज सरफेस सेपरेटिंग द टू मीडियम. सो वेन लाइट ट्रॅव्हल फ्रॉम डेन्सर टू रेअर, इट बेंड्स अवे फ्रॉम द नॉर्मल. It bends away from the normal. In the first case, light is traveling vertically without any deviation. So, angle of incidence is zero, angle of refraction is zero. In the second case, you see A, B, C, D, E. Like you can give the name. O, B. The first angle of incidence I1 less than IC, corresponding angle of refraction R is equal to R1. Again I2 less than IC, R is equal to R2. Third case, I3 is equal to IC. At that time R is equal to 90 degree. When I4 greater than IC, and at that time no refraction. म्हणजे जसं जसं अँगल ऑफ इन्सिडेन्स इन द डेन्सर मीडियम वाढत गेलं, तर अँगल ऑफ रिफ्रॅक्शन इन द रेअर मीडियम वाढतो. एक पर्टिक्युलर अँगल ऑफ इन्सिडेन्स, इथं I3 बघा, I3 एक पर्टिक्युलर अँगल ऑफ इन्सिडेन्स वर अँगल ऑफ रिफ्रॅक्शन. मी तुम्हाला एक वही घेऊन बेंड करून दाखवतो. तसं सपोज दिस इज वही हे बघा, ही फिक्स आहे, ही कोण असं फिक्स आहे. मग हे असं वाढत गेलं एक पर्टिक्युलर अँगल ऑफ इन्सिडेन्स वर हा अँगल ऑफ रिफ्रॅक्शन, हा जो रिफ्रॅक्टेड रे आहे तो सरळ जातो. रिफ्रॅक्टेड रे सरळ जातो म्हणजे त्या ठिकाणी अँगल ऑफ रिफ्रॅक्शन 90 degree आहे. तो जो अँगल ऑफ इन्सिडेन्स आहे I3, ज्याच्यासाठी अँगल ऑफ रिफ्रॅक्शन 90 degree आहे, वी कॉल इट एज अ क्रिटिकल अँगल. क्रिटिकल अँगल, CRITICAL, क्रिटिकल अँगल IC. So critical angle is that angle of incidence in the denser medium for which the angle of refraction in rarer medium is 90 degree. आता याच्या पुढचा विचार करा. जर आता angle of incidence critical angle पेक्षा जास्त असेल तर मग त्यावेळेस light चा refraction होणार नाही, तो पुन्हा त्या medium मध्ये refraction होणार, रिफ्लेक्शनच होणार आहे, इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन. सो वेन यू पुट द अँगल ऑफ इन्सिडेन्स इन द डेन्सर मीडियम greater than the critical angle, at that time angle of refraction is 90. The light is not refracted in the rarer medium, it gets reflected back into the same denser medium. This phenomenon is called as a total internal refraction. So first of all, I will tell you the definition of critical angle. So critical angle is that angle of incidence in the denser medium, here in the figure I3, for which the angle of refraction in the rarer medium is 90 degree. Angle of refraction in the rarer medium is 90 degree. So here critical angle IC is that angle of incidence I for which angle of refraction is 90 degree. So we can find out, means if the light is coming with the angle of incidence 90 degree, at that time angle of refraction in the denser medium is I3, that is equal to IC. Critical angle means when I is equal to 90 degree, R is equal to IC, at that time refractive index of denser medium with respect to the rarer medium is equal to sine of I upon sine of R. So I is 90 degree, sine of 90 upon sine of IC. Therefore sine of IC is equal to sine 90 upon eta with respect to what is called as denser medium with respect to it. Sine 90 is 1 upon theta. So from this, what you can say, IC is equal to sine inverse of, because the sine will come to the denominator, so sine inverse of 1 upon theta. So the critical angle of the denser medium depends upon, the refractive index. Okay. So critical angle is equal to sine inverse of reciprocal of the refractive index. जर एखादा मीडियम समजा तुम्हाला वॉटरचा रिफ्रॅक्टिव्ह इंडेक्स 1.5 आहे, मग काय करायचं 1/1.5, मग आता काय करायचं साईन इन्व्हर्स ऑफ 1.5 म्हणजे 1.5 म्हणजे 3/2, हे कोणत्या अँगल साठी साईनची किंमत आहे ती व्हॅल्यू आपल्याला काढायचं. साईन इन्व्हर्स तुम्हाला लॉग टेबल शिकवताना ते सांगणार कसं पाहता येतं लॉग साईन इन्व्हर्स. सो क्रिटिकल अँगलचा फॉर्म्युला आहे आयसी इज इक्वल टू साईन इन्व्हर्स ऑफ 1/8. क्रिटिकल अँगल बद्दल डेफिनेशन काय सांगितलं मी, critical angle is that angle of incidence in the denser medium for which the angle of refraction in the rarer medium is what is called as 90 degree, and then total internal reflection is a definition. When light travels from denser medium to rarer medium with an angle of incidence greater than the critical angle, with the angle of incidence greater than the critical angle, at that time there is no refraction of the light. The light is totally reflected into the same denser medium. Manje light refraction hot nahi, it reflected back into the same denser medium. That is called as a total internal reflection. Once again I'm telling you, when light travels from denser medium to the rarer medium with angle of incidence in the denser medium greater than the critical angle, at that time the light is reflected back into the same denser medium. This phenomenon is called as a total internal reflection. मग या total internal reflection चा phenomenon वापरून मग काही medical field मध्ये किंवा काही आपल्याला त्या optical fibers मध्ये जे telephone system मध्ये हा concept चा वापर करून आपल्याला signals पाठवतात. फॉर एक्झाम्पल तुमच्या उरसामध्ये एक फ्लॉवर पॉट सारखं असतं बघा, एक असं तार असतं त्याच्यात लाईट येते, बेंड केल्यावर सुद्धा लाईट त्याच्यावर असा म्हणजे आपल्याला बेंड होऊन असं आल्यासारखं वाटतं, है ना, फ्लॉवर पॉट सारखं दिसतं आपल्याला, है ना. ते म्हणजे काय असते की त्या ऑप्टिकल फायबर्स आहेत, त्याच्यातून लाईट जो आहे असा तार आहे समजा त्या काचाचा तार असतं त्याच्यातून लाईट जातं, असं टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन होऊन त्याच्यातून पास होतं आणि आपल्याला कोपऱ्याला वरती लाईट आल्यासारखं दिसतं. एंडोस्कोपीमध्ये एंडोस्कोपीमध्ये पोटामध्ये काय कॅमेरा पाठवून आपल्याला ते काय पुढे गाठ झाले काही